All right, we're back. Circling Back podcast coming to you live from the Washed HQ in Austin, Texas. My name's Will DeFries. To my left, David Ruff.
Man, I got to find a new source for news.
Is Texas blocking your news?
Yeah. Thanks a lot, Greg. Looking here, you guys ever just peruse the Daily Star?
I think that's only you.
Just to see like what the topics of the day are, the topics du jour. This one's interesting. It's talking about a Facebook and Instagram worldwide outage, which we remember that. Then next to it, here's another one. It says, man stuck coconut up his bum in extreme sex act. What happened next is even worse.
A coconut?
Dylan, what happened next is even worse.
Go on.
There's an X-ray.
You're not man enough to click that.
What happens next? Well,
you're not man enough to click
all right,
it.
Well, let me find out here. Hey. A man had to rush to the hospital after a coconut stuffed up his bun for sexual stimulation became lodged, leaving him with severe pain and unable to go to the toilet.
Yeah.
All been there.
It'll stuff you up.
What happened next is even worse.
Oh, my God. I don't know how to follow that.
It's a good headline.
It is. They've got some of the best, man. Mm-hmm.
What happened next?
You couldn't go to the bathroom.
I got one for Will right here. Just, I don't know if you want to pick one of the three.
No. You need to stop going to the Daily Star.
Yeah, this
Star,
is not
dude.
A good source
Who
for
Who goes
news?
To the Daily Star?
They should ban- I don't know. I just try to like expand my horizons. I'm not reading Newsmax or watching Newsmax every morning like you.
Newsmax? What do they do? Is it
fucking playing dumb, huh?
Is it real news or is it fake news?
Depends what your world is. Dylan Shivery.
That's how I read.
I don't know. I don't have anything to follow up a coconut up some dude's backside, but I am happy to be here. Newsletter week rolls on, by the way.
Yeah. Yeah.
If you're subscribed, you know what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
You got something to say, Will? Something back? Is something
no,
back?
No. I mean, you said newsletter week was back, and I fucking took that as bulletin board material, and I went to the keys.
You dusted off the old keyboard and went to work.
I took it to the mattresses, dog.
Damn, fool.
Yeah.
People yeah. loved it.
Yeah. Washed.substack.com.
Hey, and we ain't done yet. How about that?
People got a mid-afternoon drop yesterday. They got an early morning drop today. It's crazy out here. The streets are talking.
I wouldn't call your column mid.
Stop, dude. Stop. No, it was kind of fun yesterday. Kind of like spending time with an old friend. I haven't been inside her brain for a minute. It was nice to get back in there.
Better be inside.
Start
her
tinkering around.
Brain then.
What do you? What's your problem, dude?
I don't know.
You got to hornify it.
I spend too
if
much
he
time
if you keep
you.
Hornifying things, I'm gonna make you talk about your nosebleed yesterday.
Sorry, man. Pornhub's gone, so it's like I don't know what to do.
I'm very disturbed with how much you've hornified.
Don't
the show.
Act like you go to Pornhub, dude. You've never been there before.
I had an innocent nosebleed on a walk yesterday with my dog. All right, it's not anything more than that.
Okay. There are people talking. If anyone was walking around Dylan yesterday and they saw him get a nosebleed and you have pics of it, please send them to us.
If you saw my shirt covered in blood, it was just from my nose, I promise. I wasn't up to anything.
Do you think
nefarious.
It was seasonal allergies?
That's what I think.
They were significant yesterday.
That's what I think, yeah.
Mm-hmm. What seasonings are you allergic to? Cumin? Paprika?
Paprika.
What would be the worst one to be allergic to?
Seasoning?
Salt?
Yeah, salt or pepper?
Probably salt, David. Used on a lot of things.
I don't know. I'm asking the question. I think you could argue that garlic.
I love garlic. Yeah, those would all be.
Chef Tony's?
Those would all stink.
Chef Tony's would stink.
Tony Chachere's?
It's a multitude.
That's what you're talking about?
Mm-hmm.
I love that shit. I put it on my eggs.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What I don't you even know what you guys are fucking talking about right
you
now.
Know
you don't know Tony Chachere's?
Nah.
Bro. It's like, it's the Old Bay of the South.
Oh, okay. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
I think.
Old Bay of the South. Okay, so, a little Creole seasoning for the eggs?
There you go.
I can freak with that.
There you go.
I never know what to do for eggs sometimes, man. Because if like you're just in a hurry and you just make some eggs real quick, like you can salt and pepper those, but sometimes I just wonder, what more could I be doing?
Do you know what I learned recently?
Chives. You could mine the gap.
I do have an herb garden now.
I saw someone there who was making scrambled eggs put water in the eggs instead of milk, and that's how you get them fluffy. And this person learned it from a chef.
See, I just do it low and slow, baby. Keep stirring.
Okay.
He called me David Stern.
Water instead of milk, Dave.
I don't do milk.
You don't? Just mm-hmm. straight egg.
I used to. That's how I was taught, but I realized it didn't really make a difference. Noticeable.
That? How about that?
Are you a real milker?
No, I am a milker, certified.
I'm a certified milker, dude.
I love milk.
I'll drink a pint glass of it right now. I don't care.
If I had some, I'd put it in front of you.
Maybe. I've got milk in my Nalgene right in front of me.
I've stopped drinking almond milk.
Yeah, I don't drink nut milks anymore, dude. I've retired.
I'm out on the nut.
Stop, dude. You got to go back to dairy, dude.
I drink both.
Nah. No more nut milk. We're just dairy boys. Support your local farmers, dude.
I just told you I do drink cow milk. Dairy.
Get it straight from the source like Tom Green?
Tom Green?
Tom Green.
You familiar with his work?
No. A little bit, yeah.
He turned his dad's car into the slutmobile.
I know. I watched that. Yeah.
His dad had to go to work.
Not cool.
So he had to walk to the bus stop.
Slutmobile.
And then Tom drove the slutmobile to get his dad.
What a shithead. Also starred in the TFM movie. People forget that.
I need to know.
It's a big get.
I need to know who Tom Green is in Austin. If Tom Green Way in Austin is not named after the Canadian Tom Green. I really hope it's just named after the comedian, but I just need to know why that road is called Tom Green Way.
It's the Tom Green, I think.
Yeah, who's Tom Green, Dave? Is there a Texas version?
He was a Confederate soldier and lawyer.
Okay, so it's not going to be Tom Green Way for that long, if I know anything about Austin roads.
Like when Robert E. Lee Boulevard changed names overnight with no fanfare at all, like no announcement, it just switched.
They didn't even have a trumpeteer.
A.Z. Morton is now
the name. And as someone who had to take drunk Ubers back from 6th Street like every night, and I would just tell them, oh, just turn on Robert E. Lee. That night was like, what?
Threw me off.
Where am I?
One day.
Yeah. I was so confused.
Really close.
Yeah, they didn't make any announcement about that. They slow faded Robert E. Lee.
They changed the signs at like 3 a.m. one day.
Oh yeah, for sure. Yeah, one day it was one day it was Robert E. Lee. The next day it was A.Z. Morton.
Mm-hmm. That's how it be sometimes, Dave.
Yeah, I'm looking up the life and times of one Thomas Green.
Any good fun facts about him?
Well.
Was he racist?
I don't know.
Could be a different Tom Green.
It's not.
I don't know if it is.
Okay. It's not.
Yeah, I don't know if it is.
It would be cooler if it was the slutmobile Tom Green.
Yeah.
I would support that more than the Confederate lawyer Tom Green.
That's okay. Hey, we got a big episode today, boys. Bit Madness is upon us. We finally get to go through the bracket today for the first time. Have you guys looked at the bracket yet?
No, I'm going in cold.
Okay, I'm going in cold too. We're going to do that at the tail end of this episode, so tune in for that. But before we do, Exactly 5 minutes dropped beyond the paywall yesterday. It was lit. We got a little emotional talking about just, you know, comparison and stuff. We also just got wild with it, talking about vacations and shit. Go check it out. Patreon.com/CirclingBackPodcast. Tomorrow, listener voicemails drop first thing in the morning. If you want to leave one, 888-618-4422. Dave will scan your calls. Maybe we can call you back. Who knows?
I have a question.
Yeah.
Yesterday's show. Did the Gardner Snake Dave shirt come up?
It did. Yeah, it did. We talked about how it's very limited edition, mainly because we didn't sell very many of them.
Mm.
Yeah. Okay. We found a couple of people on the subreddit, though, who own one.
Yeah.
Proud owners.
More than a couple, at least four.
Yep.
Yeah.
A double couple.
Yep. If you show up to the any meetup wearing a Gardner Snake Dave shirt, I will assure you that you won't buy a drink that entire night. I'll buy you light beers on the wash tab all night.
Yeah. Absolutely.
Real snakers only.
But don't expect to be let into Bottle Blonde next door for the after party. Right.
Yeah, no guarantees for the after party.
Yeah, bring a button down in your satchel so you can change.
And you can hang out with just me.
Just Dave. Just Dave in the company cart.
Yep. Go check out wash.substack.com. It's newsletter week. YouTube.com/CirclingBack. We're doing premieres every Monday and Wednesday, so you can hop in the chat. It's at 2:30 Central time that these drop. But you can watch these episodes anytime you want. Well, let's hear from our friends over at Twillery. Meet Twillery, the performance menswear brand that brings life-changing functionality to your wardrobe. Twillery is nice enough to reach out to us and offer us some free clothing. Dylan decided to use the entirety of our credit on one single jacket.
Not the entire.
I got some good shorts that are in the running to make an appearance at the Masters.
Oh.
There's some dark green golf shorts.
I'll bust my coat out soon for y'all.
Okay. Okay.
You'll see.
Bust it out, dude. Whether you're headed to the office or the airport, Tuileries line of suits, shirts, polos, and jeans will keep you cool. They won't wrinkle, and they got plenty of stretch to keep you comfy. And to top it off, everything, including the suits, are machine washable, so no more trips to the dry cleaners. As a special offer to our listeners, you'd use Washed 18 for $18 off your first order of $139 or more at Tuileries.com. Tuileries, tailored for performance. We decided to punt yesterday when we got the Rahm Masters menu in front of us.
Because of you, Dave. You're welcome.
You're welcome, dude.
We knew you wanted to talk
about this. You're
welcome. Thanks, Dad.
Also, we couldn't pronounce anything on the menu, so we wanted to save that for you.
It'd be like that.
Okay.
It'd be like that.
I'll do my best. How familiar are you guys with Spanish cuisine?
Not nearly as familiar as I thought I was before I read this menu.
It goes like this for me. Paella, and that's pretty much it.
Same.
Yeah.
Same.
Since I'll be in town for this, do you think I could like slide through on the Lolo?
I don't think. I think it's pretty strict security at the door.
What if I wear the green Masters jacket that my family has created? Do you think they'd let me slide through?
Who could you pass for that's sitting at that dinner?
I'm lefty, so I could do Mike Weir. No one really knows what he looks like anyway, so I could shave the beard and just pray.
Did y'all know that John Rahm pays for this, the entire
Yeah, I didn't
spread?
Know that. That was an interesting fun fact yesterday from whatever that golfer's name
is. I
think
I learned that during the Spieth barbecue.
That's a hefty bill.
That's right? Why Bubba went chicken and like asparagus for everything, because he's cheap as fuck.
Mm-hmm.
He had the worst meals. I mean, I have nothing bad to say about John Rahm's dinner, but that's mainly because I don't know what some of these things even are.
I don't either.
I mean, he's hitting them with the jamón ibérico.
Even the there's like the English translation under some of these that explain what I still don't really know what some of this stuff is.
Yeah, yeah.
The main course, though, I normally would trend ribeye. However, if you're going to put turbot on the menu, then you've got my attention.
I obviously know what turbot is, but for those at home who don't, how about you go ahead and explain it?
It's a fish typically found in like the northeastern waters of the Atlantic, known for being a brackish fish.
Wow. So he's hitting us with brackish. Dude, this dude's different.
You understand? I know what brackish means, obviously, but some people may not.
Is your middle name Merriam-Webster? Well, this guy's different.
A part of the water that is kind of combines. How do I put this? For me.
Don't look at your screen.
It's the juxtaposition between the salt water from the ocean and the freshwater source from a river or stream. Combining. To create a taste that you can find in the turbot fish and what they dub brackish water.
Is this like a flaky fish? What's the consistency of a meat?
I think it's pretty trustworthy.
Okay.
We created a cocktail called the brackish.
I'm not writing. Nope, no cool joke gong for that, Dylan. Sorry.
He has his
bit, we have a cool joke gong?
I just realized he has a Bit Madness champion.
Oh, yeah. He's ready for it.
2021 El Presidente.
God dang it.
Will he get reelected? We made a cocktail called the brackish, which is essentially just an extremely dirty martini on the rocks because it looks just a little tough to look through.
Just a little brackish.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, exactly. And my we were trying to think of a name for it, and my buddy just goes, a brackish. I was like, that's a great fucking word for this cocktail, my man. It's salty water in here.
It's a jux play.
Yeah. I mean, here's the thing. I'm going to ask, if I'm sitting next to DJ at the dinner, I'm like, hey, can you go ribeye and I'll go turbot and we can just go splitsies right now? DJ's not splitting, though.
No.
DJ wants that full ribeye for himself. Mm-hmm. I'm pretty happy with a crab salad first course. That's kind of a flex.
I'd be tempted by this turbot for sure.
It's all peel, dude.
I'm going ribeye. I'm a red meat guy, but.
No, you're not.
I want to try someone's turbot, like you said.
I'm going to fill up on Mama Rahm's classic lentil stew beforehand. Lentejas estofadas. Is she in there actually cooking? Like, is she in the back kitchen just making lentil stew the entire time?
I wouldn't be surprised if she is.
That'd be sick.
Some of the stuff, I just don't know.
It's because you're not a real eater, dude. You're not an eater real.
I'm not an international eater.
Really? I feel like, is Spanish food underrepresented in America? They need to be more Spanish restaurants floating around.
Where can we go for Spanish food around
here? I don't know, dude, because we're a Mexican food city.
Facts. There was that tapas place down the street that, well, because it was at the bottom
Blasio?
Of an apartment building, it closed down now, but it was good. It was called like started with a B.
It wasn't Palazzo.
Did you say Palazzo? The strip club? It's not what I was thinking of, David.
Sorry.
No, that's not a tapas place, Dave. That's place a tap-ass place.
This place was walkable from here. It closed. Anywho.
Dude, hit that gong. Don't hit the gong. Funny,
what was it? The cool joke gong?
You lost it. You guys lost privileges to the cool man. Joke.
Who do you want to sit next to the most if you're at the Masters dinner? Who do you want to be like shoulder to shoulder with?
Gong, but not forgotten.
Zeej? David, say it.
Probably Spieth.
Mike Weir?
No, I don't know if I want to sit next to Mike Weir.
I don't think Spieth is going to be that much fun at the dinner.
No, he's not, but I want to observe him.
Okay.
You're staring at him.
I want to see what's up. What if you're across from him? Can you be across from him and not next to shoulder to shoulder with him?
Yeah, okay. Yeah, he's more, because I just want to see how he goes about eating his ribeye.
I'm sitting next to Gentle Ben. And we're just going to be super gentle with each other the whole time.
Aw.
Yeah.
Can I say something about how Spieth eats a ribeye? He puts off the vibes of someone who like cuts it up before he takes a single bite.
Oh, you're kind of right about this. That's mean. Yeah. You're kind of right, dude. You're kind of right.
Like, so he,
I think
there's something there.
I'm going to sit between Angel Cabrera.
I don't know if you want to do that.
Ask him for some smokes. Oh, yeah. Is he in trouble?
Yeah. I don't know if he's invited back.
Is he Spanish?
He's out of, no, he's Argentinian. Oh, that's
Jose. What'd he do again?
Yeah. I think it was a domestic violence situation. All
right, I'm not going to sit next to Angel anymore. I'm gonna remove Angel from the equation.
He's not invited.
Yeah, he's not invited anymore.
The last cig ripper on the PGA Tour.
But I think Dustin's probably got some smokes on him, and I know he's going to be crushing cocktails the entire time. So I'm going to sit next to Dustin and Adam Scott. I'm going to be like, Adam, what do I need to do to be hot? Can you teach me how to surf? Let me pick up your accent.
Wow, you got a lot of questions for him.
How do we get Dylan? Like,
I'm
going to
be
stuck?
Glazing Adam the entire dinner.
You got everybody's going to glaze Adam. He's the most glazable.
He is the most glazable.
He's a good looking man.
How do we get Dylan stuck at the end with like Danny Willett and Patrick Reed?
Yeah, I want you surrounded by like Bernard Longer.
No, Bernard, don't do Bernard like that.
Come on.
I think this is his last Masters that he's going to compete in.
Yeah, I'm going to put you next to Charles Schwartzel.
Okay, good. All right. Schwartzel and Danny Willett and Dylan at the end.
Come on, man.
Just mixing it up.
Don't put me down there.
And like afterward, we're like, so how was it down there? But you know, actually not that bad.
Dude, actually,
who's the middle among all these people?
Tiger.
He doesn't have a big personality.
No, I know, but everyone wants to be around Tiger.
That's true.
You got it. He's either at the head of the table. He's not like, he's not in the gray area. He's either at the head of the table or right in the middle.
Yeah.
I don't know. Nick Faldo. I can see Faldo wanting to be in middle and just talking. Talking,
Sir
talking,
Nick.
Talking. I want to get knighted.
Yeah, it's got to be.
I want to get
knighted
sick. So bad, dude. Knight a player up.
What is this word Basque that appears in half of these items?
I think it's the area that he's from, the Basque region. Isn't there a Basque region there?
In España?
Yeah, dude. Obviously, it's an autonomous community in Spain, dude. Okay. Literally, everyone knows that.
Okay. Yeah, I should have known.
Basque
sorry.
Country in the Western Pyrenees, straddling the border between France and Spain on the coast of the Bay of Biscay. Yeah, it's Basque Country, dude.
I have a wild card for the middle.
Okay.
Marco Mera.
I could see him. I could see him greasing the room real well.
I feel like Marco Mera's got some riz. Riz for the boys.
Okay.
I've touched his golf bag before.
Dude, that's huge.
Yeah.
Yeah. How'd you do it? Show us like right now on the show.
Can I say something wild, boy?
You stuck your hand in it.
I took a wedge out of it.
What?
I took a wedge out of it.
You put it back?
I put it back. Yeah, he was storing his clubs at a cart barn that I was not supposed to be in, but my boys were working, so I just slid through and I was like, is that really his bag? And they're like, yeah, he's played twice here this year. So I was like, I gotta take something out of this.
He probably has a bunch of bags. If he's keeping one there, think.
But it's still his bag.
Sure.
It's kind of like how you thought of that idea the other day. And even though someone had already thought about it and like done it, you still thought of that without knowing that it existed.
What was your idea?
It's just one of many ideas.
I don't know.
Just like Randy's script?
Yeah, Randy's been writing a script. We're not going to talk about it.
I say Wash Media script since it's
Yeah, it's our script.
Intellectually speaking.
We'll take over here.
Should we just have AI write... Conference crashers, and then we just make the edits and make it funnier.
Yeah.
This ties in a little bit with the crashers thing and the golf thing. What are we going to do about this Owen Wilson Apple TV golf thing?
I don't know what you're talking about, and I don't know if I want to know.
There's an Owen Wilson golf thing dropping.
Okay.
I think it might be good.
Why? Why Owen Wilson?
Wow, I don't know.
What's his handicap?
It's Wilson. He'll play Price Cahill, whose golf career ended prematurely 20 years ago after he gets fired from his job as a sporting goods store.
Oh, so it's like a show. It's not like a documentary. Yeah. No.
Oh, yeah. Okay. I explained that poorly.
No, okay. I thought it was like a documentary with Owen Wilson leading the charge here. And I was like, I don't know if we need that. No, this sounds great. I do remember seeing this now.
He gets fired from his job at a sporting goods store in Indiana, Randy, and his wife leaves him. He sees a troubled 17-year-old golf phenom as his way back.
See?
So it's Ted Lasso, but Owen Wilson.
His name's Price, or no, Wilson. Yeah, Price Cahill is such a good name for a pro golfer.
Really is.
I would really want to see Mighty Ducks 4 get made, where they're all just like out of shape, playing in a beer league together. Some are just going through it. They got new kids at home.
Ready? Here's the best line in the remake. Ready?
Here comes our script.
By Perfect. The
way. I woke up. The pain wasn't gone.
That's good, dude. Get it? Because they're old.
Yeah, PGP.
They're freaking old.
God, this script is going to be heat, dude.
Can you imagine how fun it would be? Like, think of Brett's Beer League, where they all do, like, their draft and stuff, and they all get hammered at a bar together. Like, wouldn't you watch that? Just an NC-17 version?
Some fucking.
We got Gordon Bombay just, like, being the old. He's like the new Hans, sharpening skates and shit.
Mike and Lisa are the stars of our movie, by the way.
We need to edit the names.
We can change
the names. Yeah, we got to edit the names. They need to be more current names. Mike and Lisa. Those are good placeholders.
Yeah.
Yeah.
There's a Ted, too, by the way.
That's good. I think we can keep Ted. We can keep Ted. Ted's a great name for a guy that works in an office.
Yeah.
Yep. Yeah, did you get that report from Ted?
Where's Ted?
I can see Ted now. Ted's a little overweight.
Tube socks.
The first scene starts in a hotel lobby during the day.
Yeah, it has to.
Yeah.
Nice. I like that you're grinding over here.
Yeah, dude. I just wrote the whole script.
That's fucking
Randy,
great.
Randy, I already beat you to the script.
Randy, bro. Whatever you've written, throw it out.
Yeah, it's done. Okay. It's trash.
Breaking news. Apparently, there's a Spanish food restaurant literally within walking distance right by us called El Raval.
So should we take this menu to them and ask them to shape things up?
El Raval?
Yeah. I think it's where Barletta used to be. Apparently, that's not there
Barletta anymore. was the name of the restaurant I was trying to think of.
Yeah, apparently, that's not there anymore. It's now El Raval. It's right next to the Pretty Kitty.
Restaurantception.
Yeah, meow. It's over there by the new Italian joint, too.
It's Italian Cucina?
And though
it's Italian.
There's a one opening next door, too, you know.
Sportiva.
More cash.
Yeah.
What'd you guys think about the first episode of Keeping Up with Sports?
Dude, they hit on all the sports. It was really good.
I think they're going to have a hard time keeping up.
Why?
Because there's a lot of sports to watch.
There's so many sports.
Well, they're going to keep up with them.
That's the thing. Can they keep up?
I'm going to start listening to Keeping Up with Sports.
Like Caitlyn Jenner and Lamar Odom.
I told Dylan, we've been waiting forever. Keeping Up with Sports sounds like a segment name for Too Much Dip. That's like a bit segment.
Yeah.
I mean, it probably was.
Yeah. Like do you guys already have a theme song that's like Keeping Up with Sports?
It's,
now.
It's a Do You Know It of Sports.
Yeah.
It's like, the most generic name.
It's just great. Indochino. Yeah, you've heard of them. It's time to start your style redemption story and look great at your next big event. We all like dressing before a big event. You need to upgrade that off-the-rack suit sitting in your closet right now with a fully customized perfect suit from Indochino. They'll even put your initials on your cufflink if you ask them to.
Buddy, oh, yeah. I just got my shirt.
Oh, yeah?
And it's gas. It's a light blue button-down with my embroidered initials right there in the sleeve, DJC in white.
Oh, yeah.
Tasteful, bold.
The white-on-white monogram is a nice touch.
Thank you.
These are suits designed to fit you, made to your exact measurements and customizations. They've got endless customization options that get the exact look you want, from buttons and vents to pockets and lapels. And it's surprisingly affordable. You got quality wools, linen, and cotton in different colors and patterns, and you can set up your measurement profile in under 10 minutes at home or make a showroom appointment. You can get one of those like swag measuring sticks. What are those called?
I don't know. Tape measure?
No, but it's not like the tape measure that you come like.
It's a tailor's tape measure.
Yeah.
We have one here.
Oh, yeah. I got one at home, and every time I bust it out, I'm like, yeah.
We measured our biceps school. With it recently.
We did.
They got new colors, fabrics, and outerwear styles added regularly, so it's easy to create your next look. Dress better than the other guys with Indochino. Go to Indochino.com and use code STEAM to get 10% off any purchase of $3.99 or more. That's 10% off at INDOCHINO.com with code STEAM. All right, we talked about it quickly yesterday, but we gotta just circle back on it today. Did it. Yeah, the Kate video. Dave, what are your takes? Do you think this is Kate? It doesn't look anything like she did in the car. So they're faking someone here.
What do you think, Dave?
Dylan put it at 81% her yesterday.
I don't think it's her only because I did not see the 8 children and I did not see John. So I don't know if it is Kate.
This is actually a different Kate we're talking about.
Are you talking Kate Middleton? The one who's at the center
Williams
of the controversy.
Probably got 8 children at this point.
The one who's been missing.
That's enough for the judges. I actually disagree. Do not
it's her.
Talk down about the king like this. You're talking reckless on me, boy.
Dude, after I saw that she was 5'9", and I rewatched the video, I'm like almost positive it's her now.
How tall is William?
6'3".
Oh.
A tall lad.
You should play in the NBA.
Whoa. My points against being her was her posture was very unlike Kate.
Wasn't
Middleton.
Queenly?
No.
Well, she's going through recovery, dude.
But she was carrying a bag, like she was looks spry. She's bouncing around.
That's my question. What in the world is in that bag? Mm-hmm. What she got in that bag?
They said that they're gonna do a grand reveal of her on like Easter.
What?
Like, that seems weird.
She's going to bust out of an egg?
Yeah, there's...
Jesus?
There's rumors that she's going to return on Easter, which is just kind of bizarre. Like, why?
Someone already did that.
Like, yeah.
Famously.
Why are you clout chasing, Kate?
She's resisting.
Like, I don't know. Like, maybe just do the video we've been talking about that's like, hey.
It's me. I'm fine. I'm here. I'm alive.
What if we had Randy disappear for a little bit and we didn't know where Randy was for a bit?
Oh, no, what would we do?
We could play into the Rainy Ripper thing. We could have Micah come fill in for him. Probably start doing numbers.
Yeah.
Okay, and then we kind of see where everything falls. Like, if things are going really well with Micah, maybe we just stick with Micah.
Okay.
But we could at least, like, have, like, a big celebratory thing when Randy comes back.
What do we celebrate, though?
Wow, thanks.
Are you ready to disappear?
How about after Bit Madness? Because
you don't think we can handle running it on our own?
I can always use to mess up Bit Madness, and I'm not.
It's fair,
Randy. We could bring you back as a contractor.
Thanks, David.
Sure.
So wait, hold on. Is this going to be like paid disappearance leave? Or
it could. It would be an internship that would turn into paid if you do a really, really good job and work long hours.
I don't know if you're capable of disappearing. Like Randy, we know that when he has time on his hands, he just creates content.
That's true.
You're not going to be able to do it. You couldn't stream? No D&D sessions with the boys? God,
we see what happens when there's a blizzard.
Can't dive into hell on Twitch?
That's you no can go.
You're going to have to change your username. Or you need a burner username for your gaming PC.
What would it be?
User 589632489617 89.
Oh yeah, I'll just send out like random emails being like, you won $100 to Kohl's or something like that.
Yeah.
It's not really them.
But it would really be you as your burner.
It'd be a phishing scam?
Yes.
All right. So I have this idea for a phishing movie.
Okay.
Should I write the script right now?
Dude.
Hold on, don't rush it.
I don't understand why they haven't made the Will Ferrell pro bass fishing movie. It's a free idea.
It'd be gas.
Will, if you're listening, just do it.
Danny McBride?
You could have a flounder cameo.
He's the number one pick for the rival in it. I do think Randy had the idea that John C. Reilly would...
commissioner.
He'd be the commissioner of the pro bass fishing community. Can you imagine the noodling scene? Like, I don't even know what's happening in the noodling scene, but the second you see Will Ferrell with a fish on his arm, like, you're going to start laughing.
That shit weirds me out.
Part of a bass fishing tournament.
No, but there's going to be a noodling scene, dude.
Like, he goes back to his roots in Oklahoma?
Mm-hmm.
What, it has to be like a whole, like, a kind of like NASCAR where you go to multiple different things. It's just multiple different fishing and different types of fish.
Exactly.
Things. So one of them is, like, a catfish
noodling. Yeah, we got Florida flats fishing. We've got, like, Louisiana stuff. We got to go everywhere.
It's a pentathlon, right? Mano y mano.
Maybe doing some turbot fishing in the brackish waters of the Northeast Atlantic.
It's good.
Exactly.
It's good. They could go to the Basque region.
Imagine if you got the River Monsters guy on there, too, as a cameo.
Those were good memes.
Those are great memes.
What's the Wonka update?
We done with Kate?
I don't know. No, I mean, Kate, we need more news on Kate. I'm okay with getting more news on it.
I don't want the saga to be over yet.
It's not. It doesn't it's seem very like much it's... not, dude. They're okay. really botching this at a level that we can't comprehend.
I just saw that the organizer behind the Glasgow Willy Wonka experience, you know, went viral famously a few weeks back.
Mm-hmm.
Said his life has been ruined by the event. Quote, I was devastated and I was sick to the pit of my tummy.
Tongue-tongue.
I was sick to the pit of my tummy.
Tongue-tongue issues.
Hey, dude, maybe just don't hold the event and refund everybody, my guy. Right?
Yeah. A lot of people will respond to this, noting, like, if it was really that bad and your life was ruined, would you really go with tummy in the quote?
It's true. It's true. Did anyone say this in the Grand X office after Day Rage?
My tummy.
What, their life has been ruined?
You had to call in with a tummy ache.
What an absolute disaster that party was.
Was the unknown there?
I don't know, but a camel
What
was.
Is this?
What one thing, one single thing could have changed Day Rage and made it into a huge success?
People showing up?
Yeah.
An attendance over 50?
There's nothing about the party that could have changed?
So I was lucky. I actually had a wedding to go to that night. So I was only there for like the first 2 hours of the event. So I missed like the bulk of the embarrassment. I got to skip out on a lot of it, thankfully.
Was it a fake wedding that you came up with so you didn't have to?
No. I was excited for Day Rage.
I don't think you were.
We even kept saying like people will show up later. Like it'll happen. They'll fill in.
Nice day for a fake wedding.
A lot of people bought tickets and didn't show up. Or maybe they walked up to the gates and were like, fuck this place, and they just left.
How much were tickets?
I don't remember. Not expensive. Probably 20, 25 bucks, something like
that. Was it Biob? Or did y'all have like bartenders there?
Yeah, it was definitely not BYOB. We served alcohol.
Wasn't Biob.
It's Biob. Biob.
Okay, sure.
I've never thrown a party that went horribly.
Oh, brag
alert. Wow, look at you.
Oh, this guy's different.
Look at this guy. He's got so many friends.
That was like my biggest fear.
I think I have low expectations for like parties that I throw though.
Sure.
So like any full kitchen is a success in my eyes. If you can get that kitchen full, you're fine.
Kitchen's where it goes down.
Yeah, dude. Like if you see people start playing quarters or something, like you know the party's buzzing.
Yeah.
Or if you see like a little crowd amassing like in the bathroom, you know something's going
like
up.
Like what?
Dylan looks like LeBron James.
Dylan on the trail. Bloody shirt.
It's a bloody t-shirt.
Oh, it's a bloody t-shirt.
Oh, he's with his dog. Hey, good pup.
She is a good pup.
Did you get any blood on her? It's got to be hard to get out of that white coat.
Good no, point. I didn't get any blood on her.
It's good. It's good. That looked hard as fuck, though.
It was nasty, man.
Yeah, dude, I haven't had a nosebleed in a minute. I don't know if I've ever had like a serious, serious nosebleed.
This is the most serious one I've ever had in my life.
Well, luckily you had a 10,000 shirt to sop it all up.
Hopefully it's not ruined. Probably
is this for real?
Yeah.
What? That he used his 10,000 shirt?
I thought that we were about to jump into a 10,000.
No, dude. Oh, if they want to come back on board.
They haven't been with us for months.
Honestly, I love their shit, dude. If they want to come back on board.
Very high quality.
They came on board like at a great stuff. Time for me when I was actually in shape. And like all their stuff fit me because it was like kind of an athletic fit. And so I was feeling real fresh in it.
Yeah,
I don't know if it's going to hit the same now that I haven't Peloton in a while.
You can borrow my bloody one.
Dude, I re-enrolled it in the Peloton membership. I went to go sign in on my bike, and my bike, just the software on it just won't work. Won't update, won't do anything. So I just had to immediately turn around and cancel it.
What?
Yeah, so I just got to get rid of this thing.
That's bullshit.
I'm definitely not going to get rid of it in an efficient manner. It's definitely going to sit in my upstairs for the next 4 years.
Why don't you just tape an iPad to it?
You could just tape an iPad to it.
Can you use it without the computer part being on?
Yeah, but that would suck.
Yeah.
That would suck. Like, I wanted to keep my stats and stuff.
You just want to see Cody.
Dude, Cody's a dog.
Are they still, they're still doing the whole shit?
Yeah, I don't think it's going well.
I don't think it is either.
I don't think it's going well.
There's a store at the mall. There's never anyone in it.
No, if you got a store at the mall, it's going bad. You're desperate.
The mall's coming back.
No, it's not.
Yeah, it is.
Dave, it actually is, unfortunately. Kids are liking going to the mall.
Dude, kids are cool, man.
They got digital cameras and shit going to the mall.
Also, if malls come back, that's legit. I'm down for that.
For the kids, though.
Right.
We don't need bloody nose guy walking around the mall making it weird.
Smoking cigs. And
remember mall walkers?
Yeah.
What, there's people that walked around malls?
Old ladies at tracksuits.
They would exercise in malls. They would walk around.
I get it.
It's very cute.
It's a controlled environment. Like, I get it.
AC?
Yeah. That's how I met my first girlfriend.
Mall walking.
Mall walking.
She was mall walking.
Then you have a...
She's way too old for me.
They should make a Helldivers, but it's mall walkers.
You got a teen couple holding hands and then mall walkers. Just chopping.
Where was the place that you'd go with like your like teenage girlfriend to like be alone?
In the mall?
No, just anywhere.
Oh.
I feel like everyone had like a spot.
Yeah. I don't want to divulge.
People would park. There were some places to park your car.
Rose at the Moon Tower?
No.
Oh. That is a real thing though now.
The Moon Tower?
Yeah, isn't there a Moon Tower?
Yeah. There's some historical significance to it as well. And not just because it was in Dazed and Confused, but there's like it meant something.
They've got the Austin baseball team, the Moon Towers.
That's cool.
They do?
You'd actually like their fucking merch,
dude. Is that
Lyerly's
team?
I don't know if he was on that team, but I know they played them. But we do know a couple of people on the team. But they've got some cool merch. I think you'd be into it, Dylan.
I'm going right now.
Austin Moon Towers. They're just like a what would you call it? Like, they're just club baseball. Like, they just do, like, Sunday games against other club teams.
Austin Moon Towers Baseball Club.
We do have some good stuff.
Come on, Dylan. Go get on that.
Dude, I could just
be an absolute weapon in one of these leagues.
They do have some cool shit.
I know. Dude, I like the navy blue hat with the little star on it.
Fuck yeah.
I know, dude.
All right.
I know.
All right.
You should get on one of these teams. You could be a weapon out there.
Oh, yeah. These guys are old. Like me.
Yeah, dude.
I love it.
They're all dads and shit.
That's fucking cool.
Yeah.
What was y'all's the first store you would go to when you walked into the mall? As a teen, not like now.
It was either like a Brookstone or Oshman's.
Oh.
What's Oshman's?
Super Sports.
Oshman's was like the Austin, super sports store. They had a little basketball area with a low hoop, and we go in there and just yam on people.
Yeah. It was pretty sick.
And I go check out the baseball gloves and shit and the bats.
We'd park in the parking garage. I only went with my family because we didn't have a mall. Park in the parking garage. Immediately go have an early lunch at California Pizza Kitchen. Immediately. Oh, yeah. Polish off a barbecue chicken pizza. And then my parents knew that if they didn't immediately go to the video game store, that they'd just hear me complaining about wanting to go to the video game store the entire time. So we just went straight there. Then we hit the Gap.
We got to
hit Eddie Bauer.
Tilt was the name of the arcade.
It's a great arcade.
North Cross Mall.
Tilt.
Yeah, I spend a lot of time.
The hottest
a lot of money
arcade in town.
At NBA Jam.
Dorn Jams.
Mortal
here.
Kombat. You know, the classics.
Time Cop. Revolution
that,
X.
That Aerosmith shoot 'em up game.
Revolution X.
Oh, that's what it's called?
Don't give up.
Yeah.
Wow, whenever, yeah.
Wow, dude. Okay.
You shoot CDs at
you shoot, yeah, those fuck people up.
Fucking weird.
That's
kind of
swag.
Yeah.
Should we do Bit Madness?
I guess.
Yo, low key. Should we do Bit Madness? Dude, I'm kind of excited. I have no clue what to even expect here.
Randy, are you ready for this?
I don't know if Randy's fucking ready.
Are you going to handle this?
Randy.
Sorry, I was looking up. We were talking about going to a Moon Tower baseball game recently. I was trying to find out.
Where do they play?
At a baseball diamond in Austin.
There are several. Which one?
You'll have to look at Google Maps.
Okay.
It's east, northeast, I think. I don't know.
Yeah, I'm not going up
there. They don't play at the Dell Diamond?
I think you should get one of the Navy hat, dude.
They're gas.
I know. Bit Madness. For anyone new to the program, Bit Madness is a listener-driven competition game. I don't know what you'd call it, where they establish all the bits that we've developed, whether it's on purpose or accidental over the last year or so. We put them in a bracket style thing that is also determined by the listeners. And now we are going to go through the bracket. Today is round one. Today's going to take up a larger amount of the episode than normal, whereas the other ones go a little quicker because we have less decisions to make. So I think we got to get after it today because these things tend to run long. Shall we just dive right in?
Randy, let's go, man.
Squiddity-dee-doo.
Okay.
Our number ones. Do you want to announce them, Randy? Do you want to be our our host for the reading the things?
Sure. Why not? Your first matchup is number one out blank way, and 16 will being all in on Celsius.
It's easy.
Good job.
Will had 2 Celsius yesterday before we even recorded.
Different.
That's Whoa! Why there was none.
I know.
Dylan went to get one. It was so depressing.
I was you so, should make her a pre-workout. I was so disappointed.
Dylan was like 3:30. Dylan's like, I want to be clear. I get through the day without Celsius.
When I had two Celsius, there were 4 left in the fridge. So I didn't take the second to last one or the last one.
I took the last one.
One of them went missing then.
Brett had it. He loved Wildberry. He loved Wildberry.
He probably took one for Brett the airplane. Brett was
out of town.
Did you have 3?
No, I didn't. Maybe I had 3, dude. Nah, as much as I love Celsius, out blank way makes me laugh every. It makes me at least chuckle every time a listener leaves a voicemail and says, "I'm out Oklahoma way."
It's moving on.
Yeah,
for sure.
One's moving on. Easy.
Agree.
What, Randy? You got to be quick with
it. Just takes 2 votes, Randy.
Buddy.
Sorry, I was going to go take a sip of water. So, all right, let's go to our next matchup.
Oh, water! It's the water, guys. My mouth.
We got. Are you hosting or am I hosting?
You go ahead.
All right. We got number 9, Fogs, Fred on good, sir, versus number 8, Randy hitting the Juby slide.
Wait, so it's Fogs.
Fogs. Can I just know if Goggs is on this? Is Goggs on this?
I don't think so. I think Goggs was a very late bit that did not make bit.
Wow. Because like I feel like
way too late in
can we change it to Goggs?
If you do Fogs / Goggs, you just make it a
I don't think so. Yeah, because then people selected Fogs and not Goggs for their own personal. We had 397 bracket entries.
Okay.
So
if this was Goggs, I would have it going on.
Yeah.
But since it's Fogs, I have to go with Randy hitting the Juby slide, mainly because Randy worked his ass off for that.
It's true.
I'll give it to Randy because he randomly did one when he was out with his friends the other night, I think.
Yes, it was at the Barbie speakeasy behind Kung Fu.
There was like no crowd whatsoever.
It's a pretty small place, yeah.
Did anyone throw you any dollars?
All right, it goes through. Juby slide.
Way congrats, to go, Randy.
It's hey, Juby thanks, slide man. To the next round.
That's not good. Next, we have number 5, The Merchant of Death versus number 12, Human Decanting.
Human Decanting's back?
Human Decanting's...
Like I said, some blue
I love a 12-5 upset, but I don't see it happening here.
Bro, don't even... No, don't trip, man.
Merchant of Death.
It's got to be Merchant of Death, dude.
Oh,
dude,
man. Dude, I was worried, dude.
We swapped him for a WNBA player.
He loves Brittany Griner. He just loves Brittany Griner.
We got fleeced in that deal. I'll say it.
Isn't she different in the paint per him?
She's a problem, bro. Her plus minus. Crazy.
Number 13, Generational Glazing versus number 4, My Son and Partner.
Ooh,
I still love saying glazing.
That's a strong 13 seed.
Yeah, like the term glazing is a perfect way just to tell someone that they're maybe just laying it on a little thick.
Why are you glazing this guy right now?
I'm going generational glazing.
I am too.
Ooh.
I am too. It's
what?
Going.
What day?
Okay. It moves
my son
on.
And my partner's just, it's not relevant enough right now. I did rewatch that movie last year. It's all time.
I rewatched it like a month ago, actually. Better than the first time.
Yeah, I liked it more the second time that I watched it.
There will be blood?
Uh-huh.
There will be blood.
Bro, Daniel Day acts his dick
there
off, bro.
There will be blood.
Maroon 5? Underrated, man. Not bad at all.
You're still doing The Merchant of Death.
Has he ever DM'd you?
Yeah, he wanted to see the booty? I'm sorry. Didn't know he wanted to see an ass.
Might need to see the booty, though.
The guy who's seen every ass on the planet wants to see more ass. What a fucking
might need
scumbag.
To see it.
Shout out to him.
Like, you don't even need to ask for it. Just DM another girl, and you'll get an ass pic eventually.
Or just go to... Never mind.
Just crazy horny.
Yeah. Just diabolical horniness.
Well.
Number 3. I wonder what's going to win here. Number 3, El Glissadente 2024 versus number 14, Will's 5-star. Review of the week.
So this is tough. Because Will's 5-star review of the week came in pretty strong late.
Yeah.
A surprising 3-seed, El Gliz.
Yeah, I honestly should maybe be higher. Will's 5-star review of the week hasn't even happened for a while. I haven't done it in probably over a month, maybe 2 months. So I have to go, unfortunately, just by that, I'm going to reluctantly go with El Glissadente 2024.
Yeah, Goggs goes through.
Goggs.
I don't have to vote then, I guess.
Goggs.
Damn, we got a food driven one. We got an 11 Scampi versus number 6 Chicken Piccata Summer. Scampi and Chicken Piccata Summer, they really were soaring shortly after Bit Madness last year as we entered into the summer season. I love a good Scampi. I have to say that Chicken Piccata That Sammy's been hitting so different lately.
Let me vote next. You're voting chicken piccata?
I'm going to go piccata just because I think piccata has more of a lasting power.
But chicken piccata summer, there's no stank on the way you say it. Scampi, no one says scampi like you idiots do.
I'm sorry, what are you
and
saying?
And so I enjoy it a little bit more for that reason. I'm voting scomps. Onus, Davy boy.
Oh, man, this is tough, especially in light of the cooking with Daryl video we were tagged in yesterday. He was making a nice chicken piccata. It looked delightful. Mm-hmm. Did it on some garlic mashed potatoes. I feel like I'm choosing between, like, you know, my two sons. Give me scomp.
Wow. Scompy, right. Baby. Upset alert. Dude, I don't want to share my chicken piccata at Sammy's next time I go. Like, I don't want people thinking that yourself. They can have a bite of it. Like,
get it yourself.
I know. I like having it left over so much.
Hey, also, wasn't Scompy born? Didn't we do a lunch there?
It was at Olive Garden for Brando's send-off.
Yeah, send-off lunch.
Uh-huh.
He chose Olive Garden.
Shout out Olive Garden, dude. Good, dude. It was good.
Wasn't bad.
We need to get that cheesecake thing on the
That's your job. Books. That's your job, my guy.
Well, Brett decided to leave.
Number 7, Dave reading wiki articles versus number 10, in-office deal cigs. See, you weren't even, you've never, have you been in the office when Brett smokes a cigarette in the office?
I feel like you've missed the two times.
You're lucky. You're lucky you're not here because it smells bad and it's not cool.
He does it.
It's a cigarette.
He does it in a way that, like, there's no fanfare. He doesn't have any kind of swag when he does it.
He just creeps over there, grabs a cig and sparks up.
But I feel like the first time he goes, hey guys, deal, like, he almost like announced it as if we weren't going to smell it. We're like, oh.
Hey, I'm smoking a cigarette. Like,
something like that.
Yeah.
He also looks so gun shy while he's smoking the cigarettes. But yeah.
That's a big part of it.
Like, yeah, he doesn't own the cigarette.
He's not cocky enough with the cig.
If he just sat at his desk and kicked his feet up and lit one up and started smoking at his desk, but instead he like emerges coyly from the conference room and is like got it like in his lips smoking it like a little kid would smoke it.
Struggling to light it.
He's not a real smoker.
No, he's not a real smoker, dude.
What an idiot.
He's not a real smoker. I love the idea of office cigs, though.
I do, too. I just haven't been around for one. Plus, it's dope when we close a big deal.
Yeah, I mean, anytime you get to smoke a cig in the office, it's celebratory. I'm going cigs. I'm not ready for cigs to go.
I'm going to put it on Dylan. I'm going wiki articles.
I'll go deal cig.
Okay.
No offense to you. I do enjoy you reading a wiki article.
I don't even do that, so.
Right.
I'm being real right now, Dave.
Oh, shit.
45 minutes late.
I missed a couple days.
You got number 15, backwards hat Will versus number 2, juxtaposition. Dude, Dylan is so afraid of backwards hat Will.
I'm in the blender right now.
Dude.
This might be an upset. Folks,
dude, you don't like backwards hat Will. He's cocky.
He is cocky.
He's got all his ducks in a row.
You turn into an asshole when your hat goes backwards.
What are you talking about?
Just saying.
That's who I am.
I don't know.
I'm just stealing people's girls. Will he go backwards hat for the fifth week in a row on Vibe Mails tomorrow? People are wondering.
Oh God, I'm going. Oh fuck, I hate to say this. I'm going juxto.
Juxta on him.
I'm asked that juxta button.
Dude, we had to have it go through. He hates juxtaposition. I'm going number 2 juxtaposition.
Backwards hat Will is an asset to the Patreon, the paywall content. But juxtaposition, like having to explain what that means to Dylan, like because he just obviously does not, he wasn't familiar with the term. It's just so funny to me every time we do it.
It's embarrassing. He doesn't know what it means.
It's pretty crazy. Mm-hmm. At least now your vocabulary grew a little bit.
Yeah, thanks for teaching us all what juxtaposition meant.
Not all, just you.
Yeah, just you.
Maybe Randy.
We're in the retail therapy bracket now. It's Zocard number 2 with number 15, 10 million fireflies. That was a short-lived bit, but it was a good bit. It was good.
That did not last.
I hated that bit.
Why?
Because you couldn't believe your eyes?
Yeah.
That song stinks.
It sucks that it has to go up against Zocard because Zocard obviously has to go through.
Pretty sure that bit originated on Dave's couch.
Fireflies?
Yeah.
Yeah, it did.
Was that a...
Dave's couch week was so fun.
Oh, my God.
I would go back. Take me back. Take me back.
I mean, you can come over and sit on the couch.
Okay.
You're all welcome.
I'm going Zocard.
Was that last year?
I'm going Zocard.
That's crazy.
Some of these aren't from last year.
Okay.
This was from late summer last year.
I mean, 10 Days
Fireflies, dude. No, but it's Elgiz 2024.
Whenever, dude.
It's a new bit because it's a new presidential run.
Zocard? Yeah, Zocard.
It's got to be Zocard,
that feels
dude.
Right. That feels right.
Number 10, Dave JFK voice.
Done like versus twice.
Number 7, Dylan sliding in DMs. What, dude? If I opened up your DMs with Casey Musgrave right now, what would I see?
You see two unanswered messages.
And would one of them be a Mario meme?
Yes.
Okay.
One of them is you drop this queen.
Okay.
Single
that,
though.
That one, the Golden Bachelor lady, Blanche or whatever it was.
It wasn't Blanche. It's Golden Girls.
Yeah, I did message her.
Like, what if Casey gets in the squad eventually and she's hanging out with us and she follows you on Instagram and goes back and is like, oh.
Okay, if Casey gets in the squad somehow, Will, which would be a huge
she
situation.
Will be in town very soon.
I'll go delete those messages so she can't go dude, back. Like, hey.
No, that just makes it more weird.
I pre-ordered her vinyl and like, it's just stuck in Kansas. This happened to my Taylor Swift vinyl that I pre-ordered. I'm done pre-ordering vinyl from whatever record label they fucking have together.
What's going on in Kansas?
why does this stuff all get whatever? All right, I'm going Dave JFK voice in an upset here. I like the Dave JFK voice.
I do too.
And I don't. You're not sliding into enough DMs of famous people.
I'm sorry that I don't slide into enough DMs.
Why don't you slide?
I slid into Tiffany Gomas's DMs.
That worked. She kind of slid into. I think she was more rabid for you than you were for her.
Some would say.
What kind of plane was she flying on? Was it a Boeing?
More like a Boeing.
She did give a give me JFK, I guess.
It's right, a joke, the
voice we've done twice.
Oh, it's good.
You've done it much more than twice.
Number 6, Dylan stealing your girl, and number 11, Real Eaters.
You know, for the record, I've never stolen anyone's girl.
You sure do never. Talk a mean game, though.
It's Real Eaters.
Is it?
Yeah. I'm voting Real Eaters, dude. What exactly? There's no way.
I'm new here. I've never listened to the show. I'm liking what I'm hearing so far, this but is, what's a Real Eater?
Got this one.
A Real Eater James. Is like if you have scampi and piccata in front of you and you finish both.
Urban Dictionary might disagree with that definition.
Right. What would I don't frequent. What does Urban Dictionary say?
I have it from memory if you want me to say it.
Okay. Go ahead.
I believe the Urban Dictionary definition was pretty much a hoe that gun suck your dick and swallow your kids.
Okay.
Is how it was put in.
Mine just says a person who is eating.
Yeah. That's okay. What I said.
Definition 1, a person who is eating. Definition 2, a fat chick. Definition 3, someone who performs oral sex.
That seems a little inappropriate, but I'm going to stick with number 11, Real Eaters.
Real Eaters.
Yeah, I'm going to go with the Eaters.
Eaters, number 14, the Austin Ripper. I guess the Rainy Street Ripper.
Oh, my God. Yeah,
versus Let's Go Out This Weekend. Let's Go Out This Weekend.
You know how hard it is when you're doing an Indochino read and you mention a big event? To not shoot down the thing.
Randy, please. All I'm asking is for you to take the video that I sent you earlier of Conor McGregor saying, Lil Woodrow's Let's Go, and then doing Let's Go Out This Weekend and putting it over an EDM beat that drops for This Weekend of Fun.
I think I could do that.
Like, that please. Sounds, that's honestly sounds great.
Hey, find a way.
Okay.
Let's make it. I want to make a piece of merch that just says, Let's Go Out This Weekend.
I vote Let's Go Out This Weekend.
I definitely vote Let's Go Out This Weekend.
That's all it says on the shirt.
Mm-hmm. Let's go out this weekend.
I think the last time I talked to T-Man, he was like disappointed that I wasn't still following Timon.
I definitely still follow Timon.
And I was like, dude, you're right. So I refollowed him, and man, he has been on a tear.
Number 4, backers giving their stats on voicemails. Number 13, hi Dave.
No, no.
Hi Dave.
No. That's no. Backers giving their stats on voicemails.
I really enjoy it.
Oh, it's shucks.
A great addition to paywall content.
We did a supercut video of that.
You know what's not a good addition?
Hi, Dave.
If this was touching base and I was doing the voicemail screening, I would always play a voice. I would always select anyone who gave their stats at the beginning. I love when people give their stats.
It's a really good bit.
It makes me very happy.
It's moving on for sure.
Well, unless the stat is about your private parts, which someone does, and that someone is a friend of the show, and I have to say, I'm not playing it.
Homie, don't play that.
Who is it?
I'm not going to name names, but it's just like way too in detail.
Like girth and length? Like what's going on?
Kind of.
Hard and soft?
Unless it's boobies. It's just different.
12, Old Gene versus number 5, Standing on Business, which Dylan ruined almost before it even was out of his mouth.
That's what I do. It was really incredible how he ruined it.
I was kind of ground floor on that.
You kind of were. I still like Standing on Business.
I caught it when it was cool and right before it became uncool.
That's made it uncool, John.
Yeah, I made it. Yeah, right.
Yeah, where did Standing on Business even originate?
I think
Black Twitter.
Okay.
I like Standing on Business. My favorite place
ever. Drewski has a very famous video, which is a good one if you want to get into his catalog. I'm going to go with SOB.
I love Old Gene, but I just think
Old Gene's had his time.
I don't know if Old Gene's got it this year for the 12 over 5 upset.
Standing on Business.
Maybe we'll hear from Old Gene in Content Week.
I think Old Gene's made every single bracket. So, you know, they're just
longevity play.
No. Yeah. Yeah. Nothing to be ashamed of here, Gene. Number 8, Content Week versus number 9, Back Blown Out of Plasties. Is that the same thing as a bacchiotomy?
I don't know, because neither one is a real surgery, so.
Well, you've gotten both of them.
Okay.
Well, what did Dave get done? He got his eyelids done. He got the buccal fat removed from his eyelids.
The buccal fat?
You haven't heard about that?
No.
That's like the whole thing that celebrities are doing now.
From eyelids?
No, it's just from your cheeks.
Oh.
They get their cheeks slimmed down.
Can you just get them clapped?
That's good. I'm going back blown out of plasties.
Yeah, I'm going to do it. I stand in solidarity with Dylan, back blown out of plasty. Because I don't, even though like his health condition is not a bit, it's an homage to him.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you, Dave. Mm-hmm. I do appreciate that.
It's crazy you're willing to get all these surgeries on your ass, but you're not willing to simply bleach it. Number 16, okay. Goblin mode.
Yeah.
Versus number 1, What's the Damage?
A 1 seed?
Wow.
That's a surprising 1 seed for me. Did they have a good regular season against some easy opponents?
Apparently their non-conference was pretty strong.
I thought their season last year was much better.
Yeah, their season last year was much better. You're right, Randy. Very right.
Are they about to get Purdue'd?
Oh, see, Randy? People hate Goblin Mode, Will. That's the issue.
Yeah.
Like, people don't like him.
The lazy act.
They just don't like it.
What's the Damage is pretty.
It's so personal.
Like, I know.
What did you spend on that?
Someone asked me that, like, about, like, after I, like, someone commented that after we had Charlie.
Well, babies are quite expensive, actually.
Oh, what's the damage on that?
What was the deductible?
I don't know. I don't know, Dave.
What's the Damage moves on, right?
I'm going to go What's the Damage just because I know that listeners hate Goblin Mode Will.
I've never seen a negative thing said about Goblin Mode Will.
I've been told to my face that Goblin Mode Will is not a savory bit.
Who are these people?
So half the first round is
finished. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Round one is half done, baby.
Okay.
We're going to the mail-in side of the bracket. It's a blank play, number 1 seed versus number 16. Sure.
Who said, what's that from?
Isn't sure just how Randy responds to things?
That's how I respond to Brett in that thing.
Sure.
Sure.
I'm going, it's a blank play.
Just the least energy possible. Yeah, yeah, for sure.
Because that has infiltrated my brain to the point where it's not even a bit. I will just say it for things. Like, it's a texture play. It's a moisture play. It's a salt play.
Dave ate Triscuits in Montana or something. He said it was a texture play.
Was. Dude, no one's eating Triscuits for the texture, dude. It's like eating straw.
I feel like I had some back on that. Was it DJ Bean on Team Triscuits?
Dude, Triscuits are so... Dude,
no one buys Triscuits on vacation.
Hey, I just found another definition of eater.
Okay.
It just says, she a eater, and it says, she a thought that's very known.
Yeah. That's probably the most, like, spot on.
Yeah, I like that one. She's a thought that's very known.
Person 1, that's your girl? Person 2, yeah, bro. Person 3... She a eater, bro. Straight thotty.
That's so rude to say to somebody.
Yeah, you can't say that to somebody.
Person 3 needs to fucking chill.
Number 1 goes through. It's a blank play.
Person 3 is a dickhead.
Number 9, Brick versus number 8. Don't clip that, Randy.
Oh, it's Brick. It's Brick.
Well, hold on. Let's talk about this at depth.
Brick's got Elite Eight.
No, potential. You just know. You just want Brick to go up against Gliz at some point.
No, I don't. It's Brick.
Brick.
What did he wear on the plane?
Probably a fucking Jackson Hole shirt.
Probably a rugby shirt. Oh,
did he set up his pee flare yet?
Is he going to
rock that? Yeah, he pee flared last night.
Okay.
Does he rock Jackson Hole shirt to Jackson Hole?
He put his girlfriend in the pee flare, though. It doesn't really...
No, he pee flared first.
Oh, did he?
And then the next one, yeah, so, you know.
Oh, babe, no.
No, see, look, follow up.
See,
oh, she hasn't uploaded
yet. Yeah, she definitely looked at him. Did you just shoot up a pee flare? Put one up on me.
That's how that conversation went.
Hey, Brick, congrats. You're going through. Number 5, Dylan still thinks he can take every animal versus number 12, ChatGPT-FMs.
That's so stupid.
You can't.
I don't really do that much.
But you still think it. We just don't talk about it as much anymore.
One time I said I could take a cheetah, and I stay. It's not like a crazy thing to say. And people like, oh, Dylan thinks you can take any big cat there is, probably a polar bear.
Y'all
like,
don't
no, I never said
know.
Any of those.
Y'all don't want to know what he said about a hippopotamus recently. Full grown adult male.
In the water.
You said that with your core strength, it could not take you underwater.
Chat GPT FMs is moving on for your boy. Because those were funny.
You know, I'm going to put the anus on Will.
It was flash in the pan, though.
That anus
quick.
On me, dog.
I'm going to go ChatGPT-FMs.
I don't think number 5 is like relevant enough right now. And I feel like we could run back ChatGPT-FMs. I also just love the phrase ChatGPT-FMs. I think they might be a sneaky upset in the first round that goes down in the next round. I'm going with ChatGPT-FMs for now.
Okay.
I don't think it's got staying power at all.
It was too quick.
It's too quick, dude. Flash in the pan. Number 13, the ops. I don't want to do this one versus number 4, Goon Cave. I love the ops, dude.
You have a goon cave at your new place.
I'm going goon cave just to get out in front of it. I'll be honest. The first time I heard the phrase goon cave, I made some assumptions about the word that were maybe incorrect. But by the time that I realized what I had done, it had gone too far. So I'm sticking with goon cave. I got diamond hands when it comes to goon caves.
I'm going to go with the ops. I'd like to put the onus on Dylan.
Goon Cave moves on.
Wow, really? Wow.
I wasn't here for the ops. I was out of town.
Dude, you got something. I like that you're in on Goon Cave. You're
I'm not in on it, but I wasn't here for the ops.
You're the number one op of real beaters.
So can we make the Make Texas Goona again? Heads?
No.
If it wins.
Feedback on that hat.
I had some likes.
How many?
A couple.
Six.
No, it was probably more like 50. I don't know.
Number 3. That's life. When you're a motherfucking frat star.
Okay.
Versus number 14, Cream Corn Goose Guy.
I can't believe they used that line in that fucking movie.
The last that's line. Like when you're a motherfucking frat star.
Yeah, it's like.
The last line.
And then it just cuts scene. Like, that's the end of the movie.
Yup.
Wasn't there a secret scene at the end if you stuck around through the credits?
Goon Sash?
Like a Marvel one?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I don't recall.
It was Dorn and Bacon wrestling.
Dorn's got a paddle.
It was Dorn. Just,
we never got the money to make that sequel.
Cream Corn Goose Guy.
I fucking hate that guy.
That guy stinks.
He does stink, but that's why, for me, he's moving on.
I've moved on from him in my life. I don't know if I want him to be a presence hovering over me until Monday next week.
What does he have on, like, stuck to the side of his car, like a magnetic?
A cup.
His magnetic water bottle, dude.
That's right. That's how outdoorsy this guy is.
What a total boner this guy is.
I have photos of him, dude. Guy's a psycho.
Ugh.
Where's he at on any given Friday or Saturday night around Rainy Street? Just asking.
Yeah, seriously.
Asking questions. Person of interest.
It's good that you moved out of there.
I know. He was going to kill me.
He was.
The way that his neck snapped back to stare at me as he drove by one day was unlike anything I've ever experienced. I hate that guy.
I'm voting for That's Life When You're a Motherfucking Frat Star.
I'm voting for That's Life When You're a Motherfucking Frat Star.
Wow. Upset. That's Life When You're a Motherfucking
Frat Star. There it is.
We'd love to know what that song was that's ending there, too.
Terrible, dude. It sounds like a Disney Channel, like in between commercials
it
song.
It really does.
Number 11, Pigpen versus number 6. What?
Can someone remind me what Pigpen is?
Oh, that's not a good omen for this bit. Pigpen was, I think it's just, is that, that was when Dave was pay-pigging.
I think it was the name of the studio.
Oh yeah, and then we called the studio the Pig Pen for like a week there.
Got it.
Yeah.
Okay.
I mean, I love my Aziz voice. It's the only impression I can actually do at this point. I can't do a Trump. I can't do a Biden. My Christopher Walken never hits. It doesn't sound right. Aziz, though, it's all I have.
I'll go Aziz.
I'll give Aziz the nod.
I like that it says Will's on Z's voice.
I was about to ask, have I been saying it wrong all these years?
Yeah, you haven't gotten his name right.
Good stuff.
Number 7, Nice With It versus number 10, Carve. Carve. I love Carve, dude.
I do too.
Like, they had the worst service of all time the other night, and I still fucking love these guys. I'll say it, dude. Their horseradish cream sauce might be goated.
Oh, with the prime rib.
With that prime rib, dude.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, my gosh. Anytime,
that's such a good order.
Anytime you have a normal pour of wine and then you have the Carve pour that's bigger, like, that's just sick.
Who's not getting the Carve
pour? I'm going Carve. Imagine.
I'll go Carve, too.
I love going there, then ordering a bunch of meat, maybe like a board of meat, and then not really eating any of it because your appetite's gone.
Yeah.
Why'd the appetite go away?
I don't know.
They have nice specialty cocktails too.
Then you
they
just do. Give your waitress they like do. All like 3 pounds of just
give her the beef. Here's the prime beef. Yeah. Lady.
The car's moving on, right?
Yep. Number 15, the Dumb Cumsters, which is the name obviously for people who listen to the cinematic universe of Marvel.
The one episode we did.
Yep. They're the Dumb Cumsters. So and then number 2, Pledge Voice. I assume that means,
oh, little Pledge. I got bad news for Dumb Cumsters.
Is that Pledge Voice?
I think the Pledges are moving on.
Did we break your skin with a paddle?
Oh, okay.
I'm sorry.
You can't sit down for a week?
Have you been living in a dumpster for the entire semester?
Oh. Did you fail your class because you couldn't go? Did we make you drop out to mess with you? Did your parents pull you out of school?
You get a 0.8 GPA this semester.
I had a pledge brother. Oh. I was in a pledge brother. I knew a guy who got a bid, rushed, and we didn't realize he was never enrolled in school.
Love that, dude. Love that. That's so badass.
In fact, not only just went all the way through.
That's great.
And we're like, oh.
Dude, that's real frat stuff.
So you don't go here.
He's a real fratter.
Didn't go anywhere, as it turns out. Shout out to him.
He's just a townie?
Not even a townie. Just like,
dude, he just wanted a frat.
He was just hanging out. Which, I mean.
Did he pay dues and shit?
Dude, a girl that I knew was dating a guy who used all of his student loan money, and he was like, oh shit, I'm just going to ball. He just didn't enroll in school and spent all the money on shit.
That's the worst idea of
I know.
All time.
We told the girl, we were like, you need to get away from this guy. What this did he is spend the biggest red flag.
Did he invest it?
I don't know if he invested it.
Probably not.
That would have been a smart play.
Hey, Pledge Voice, congratulations. I'm voting for you.
Oh, you got to go to the next round? Did you live to see another day?
Yeah.
You're going to wish you didn't.
Yeah, that moves on for sure. Oh. That's a good one.
Oh
no.
Whoa, dude, Randy.
I don't know what that was.
No, Randy's doing a great job working this. I wouldn't be able to do it. We have number 2, Pledge versus number 15, Rhea Time.
Oh, God.
I'll be honest. I hate Rhea Time.
Rhea Time stinks.
Why is it spelled like a woman's
name? It does stink usually.
It's not
right.
Spelled correctly. It's spelled like the Succession character.
Yeah, that's just how it was on the bracket. That's how I
hate Rhea Time. I don't like poop humor. I'm going Pledge.
Pledge is great.
Yeah. We even have a pledge in the studio.
I think Rhea Time could be something big. I think for me, Rhea Time moves on.
Wow. They want the upset, but unfortunately, it's not happening. Pledge
Why?
Moves on. Dude, that was one of the funniest segments we've had.
I know, but.
We've had in months.
Dude, this is Randy's best bit ever.
It's Rhea Time.
It's Randy's only good bit. Number 10, Mondo's. Versus number 7, Pints with the Lads.
This is a
I just don't think
bracket.
Pints with the Lads has this like the oomph here. It's got to be Mondo's.
I enjoy Mondo too much. I don't know why.
Everyone wanted Mondo's in Rhea Time meeting up, but it's not.
Here's the thing.
Poor Brett uses the bathroom one time during an episode when we didn't have the wall up.
I know
he's
I said
Mondo guy.
I don't like poop humor, but the word Mondo is so great.
Dude, he drops Mondo's.
It's just the word Mondo. Like, it's just, we're the only podcast trying to make Mondo a thing again, and it's just crazy.
Mondo moves on from me.
Yeah, Mondo's going. I love Pints with the Lads, but.
Right.
Number 6, Vortex Bottles versus number 11, Ski-wee.
Ski-wee.
Dude, this is tough for me.
That is tough, man.
We should do a vortex bottle tweet, actually.
Every time I see or think about a vortex bottle, it makes me happy. Just the way the liquid leaves the bottle. You understand?
So fast.
Yeah.
Ski-wee was from the list of Gen Z terms.
Ski-wee.
The teacher banned in a class, remember?
Yeah, what a prude. Just let the boys say the words.
Ooh, I'm going to vote for... I'm going to go vortex bottles on this.
I'm going vortex.
All right, I'm tweeting Miller Lite right now. It's been a minute.
Okay.
This is a live tweet. If you could go like it in real time, everybody. Thank you. Number 14, that's our biz dev guy versus number 3, pay pig.
How did that's our biz dev guy originate?
Mondo's.
Was he doing something ridiculous?
He was probably doing something fucking stupid, and we were like, that's our biz dev guy. It's pay pig, dude.
Is it because he bricked his outfit?
Dude, when Dave got dinner? A slap on the wrist from the FAA about, or not FAA, whatever it was, for sending out too many Venmos, that was such an epic day in the studio.
What do they want me to do? Not send money to random women that I've never met and never will? What the fuck's their problem?
Hey, they can stop you from exchanging money, Dave, but they can't stop you from commenting on their Instagram supporting them.
That's a great point, Queens.
Great golf swing.
Imagine just giving some young lady money just because you think she's attractive. She's never going to even thank you for it.
Well, it's not all about looks.
He doesn't have to imagine it, dude. He does it all the time.
Pay pig moves on for your boy.
Yeah, it's pay pig. Number 4, fraternity leave versus number 13, make messy in my nappy. Well, I hate this side of the bracket right now.
Yeah, this is
too much
tough.
Poop humor.
There's way too much poop humor that I'm going to vote against every single time except for Mondo.
Easily the filthiest side of the bracket.
It's gross, dude.
Make messy in my nappy.
Fraternity leave, I think it's got to be fraternity leave as a nod to our sons. I mean, Dave and I both got to do it this year.
Wait, was make messy in my nappy, did that come from the Daily Star?
Yeah, it did, yeah.
See, you guys don't read that as your number one source of news.
No, we don't.
Fraternity leave moves on for me.
Yeah, it's fraternity leave. Number 12, women in STEM versus number 5, Dave being the favorite. Dave being the favorite's not a bit. Yeah, Dave's just the favorite.
He's just flat out people's favorite.
And I don't think women in STEM are a bit either because I support them no matter what.
I don't think women are bits, buddy.
I'm sorry?
I don't think women are bits, buddy. There's a comma there.
Okay. Bits, buddy. Huh. Dave is everyone's favorite.
I stand in women in STEM, so you know for me.
I'm going women in STEM because Dave being the favorite's not a bit. It's just the reality.
I would have voted for Dave being the favorite, but I guess it doesn't matter.
Yeah, bitch.
Just want to go on record.
So it's women in STEM?
Women in STEM.
Number 8, Dylan following AI models to number 9. Bad Boys of Small Podcast.
I follow one AI model, it's not a big deal.
That's your name?
You follow the shit out of her though.
Mila Sophia.
How much money have you sent her?
I'd rather not say.
Is she doing well?
She's gained a little weight.
Really?
Yeah, I swear.
Okay.
Not that anything wrong with it, but like the AI model, like she clearly has put on a few pounds, which is funny to me.
You don't know what she's going through?
I know. I don't. Hopefully it's just...
Is this on Instagram or
healthy weight.
Is this on Instagram or Twitter that you follow her?
Twitter.
Okay.
It's healthy weight. She looks great still.
Okay. Okay. She's filling out, man. She's getting older.
She's maturing.
I can't believe this is such a ridiculous thing to follow. She's doing numbers, dude.
Of course she is. She's beautiful.
She's got 150,000 followers on Instagram.
She's living in Helsinki.
She releases YouTube videos, but it's just a slideshow of her pictures. It's really ridiculous.
I hate this. I'm going Dylan following AI models.
It's just one. Dave?
It's AI models all the way.
Yeah, okay. Dylan following
models. It's not even close. This is never a game.
This is a good final matchup for the day. We've got Dirty Chai Bread at number 16 against Pants Beer number 1.
That's our biz dev guy.
Oh, that's where that came from. Right?
Maybe it was definitely said in that context.
It was.
Dude, I love a Pants Beer, though.
He had a coffee meeting with someone, and he ordered a Dirty Chai Latte.
Because like, we asked him, because we know he doesn't drink coffee. So I'm like, wait, hey, you go to a lot of coffee meetings. What are you ordering? Just curious. It's the dirty chai latte.
With a little cinnamon on it, some whipped cream.
Which is fine. It's just,
I mean,
I don't know, man.
Not when you're staring across maybe a business associate.
Yeah, what if it's a real tough negosh?
Pants Beers moves on for me. It's a one seed.
God, my pants have been so dry lately. Yeah, we got.
Do you think Guinness would let us do a Pants Beer video for?
Something tells me no.
Nope.
Okay.
But we're not drinking it.
That's true.
We'll talk to legal. Hey, thanks everyone for that. For putting together this bracket. This has been fun.
That was fun.
Oh. Ooh, it's time for This Weekend in Fun. Presented by our friends over at Roback. You know your boy's going to be strapped up with that Roback when he goes to the Masters. Do you guys hear him going to the Masters? Not this weekend.
I heard, yeah. I'm excited for you.
I have too much Roback to select from for the Masters, dude. Because they make polos, quarter zips, hoodies, joggers, shorts, pants,
they everything. Just released their Looper short, which is, it's a techie, stretchy golf short. Call it a golf short. You can wear it wherever you want. But it has belt loops in it. First of its kind from Roback.
You love to see it.
They fit so well.
You love to see it. They've got their whole Masters collection out right now. They got azaleas on everything. It's just a beautiful thing to see. Go get in the spirit. Roback.com. Backer 20 gets you 20% off of your first order. Load that card up. Dylan, what are you getting into this weekend?
Thanks for asking, Will. Don't have anything on the books for Friday. Parks has his second baseball game Saturday morning. His first one is tomorrow, actually. So I will be at his game Saturday morning. It's going to be a beautiful weekend. I will be spending most of it outside, hopefully.
What's the weather?
High 78 and sunny Friday and Saturday.
Wow.
So beautiful.
Wow. Oh, my God. It's a great weekend to dump an entire beer on your crotch.
Mm-hmm. It absolutely mm-hmm. is. That's all I have. It's just those two things. Sunday, I get Parks is with me. We'll go do something. That's it, man.
What's so funny, David? Low key. What's so fucking funny, David?
I was just thinking about like you and Brett on a call with an alcohol sponsor. And then being like, we love everything you sent over. I think you accidentally sent one where you spilled beer on your pants. And like that one obviously isn't getting posted. You're like, whoa, what?
No, that's our number one idea, actually.
That's kind of the lead. That's the feature.
I thought about submitting a tapping in photo where you're putting your finger in the beer, but I didn't think they'd go for that either.
No, you can't finger the beer.
No. Everyone's looking at you, David. What are you doing this weekend?
What the fuck is this guy's problem?
I hate that bit for some reason, the finger in the beer thing. I don't know why.
It's stupid.
It's so stupid.
I did it one time.
Tapping in. You don't need to do that.
It's because you're 40, dude.
Do it again.
Tapping in.
You want me to make that the thumbnail?
That's not a thing.
I want you to make that a whole clip, baby.
No. There's much better stuff to choose from.
You're asking me about my weekend?
Yeah. Very clearly.
Daddy's going to be, dude, I'm slamming my laptop shut today. No, I'm actually not. I'm having my thing tomorrow. My pros.
You're going to have to expand on this.
My procedure. Having it tomorrow morning. So I'm going to be all volumed up, maybe. I don't know what they do. And Dylan, if you ever want to make a baby with me, you got about 24 hours, buddy.
Okay. All right. Let's see how your schedule looks later.
Yeah, so we're it's going away.
Is it kind of sad?
Yeah, is there any existential thing to this?
Yeah.
Actually, I guess technically you could reverse it at some point, but
that is nice knowing that. I say hopefully it doesn't come to that. I don't want it. It is a little bit weird.
A little bit like, okay.
Yeah, I mean, I said this to Alyssa. I said, my purpose as a man on this earth is gone.
No more little Dave's running around.
Yeah, I'm a man. I'm 40. I got two lads. Pretty happy.
Handsome
with them.
Lads.
Three. Man, I don't know how I could do a third, We're barely getting by with two.
Yeah.
Will knows. Very tough.
Yeah, brother.
Brother. I don't know, man.
I'd say to you.
It's tough, Dylan, yeah.
You know what I'd say to your swimmers if I was the lead singer of Incubus?
What?
Nice to know you. Goodbye.
I hate what just happened.
Incubus.
He was so hot. He would perform without a shirt on.
Oh my God. Brandon is so hot.
But he wasn't muscular, but he was just had a perfect body. People did say that.
Saw some dudes. They were in a boat on Lake Austin. It was really early in the morning when I was letting Rosie out and very glassy out there. No wind. And the dude was just slowly in the no-wake zone, just going through it. And he was just blasting Incubus, floating down the river. And I was like, man, this dude's doing a lot right now. Boy, like, you can't play the song Floating Down the River while you're floating down the river.
That's massage music.
So you're just straight lamping this weekend around the crib. So
I'm sitting on ice. I'm gonna be so bored. I do want to start. I'm gonna finish the gentleman. I got two more left. I'm gonna start Mr. and Mrs. Smith. Probably. You're gonna make a gentleman joke?
I was gonna make a joke about finishing gentlemen, since you're not gonna be.
It's a joke at my it's my pee-pee expense.
It's a vasectomy joke.
No. I'm glad you're finding humor, and
I'm jealous, dude.
I'm sitting on your ass watching TV all weekend. That's awesome.
If I make any gumbo this weekend or anything, you want the gift of it?
I don't think there's any dietary restrictions, but nothing's gonna make me take a mond. I'm sorry.
Yo, you don't want my gumbo, dude. It's extra spicy.
Oh, that doesn't sound good. That does sound great, actually.
Yeah, what the fuck?
Sorry.
You said my gumbo doesn't sound good?
Well, we've got first T-ball practice is Sunday. I don't really know. I'm going to go, but we went over this. I don't know if I'm supposed to, like, I don't want the coach to think I'm, like, lazy. You know, because I need to be out there, like, hey, I'm going to help. But realistically, I don't want to do any damage. I'm supposed to, like, not do anything active for at least a week.
You're not expected to contribute.
Yeah. I know, but I want to be hanging over the fence like, come on, chill it down. Come on, chill it down. Anyway.
Yeah.
So, yeah, that's what I'm doing. Oh, hey, March Madness, dude. See if my bracket gets busted.
Who's your champion?
Purdue, man. What the fuck?
Nice, dude.
What kind of question is that? Let's go.
Love that.
Windy. Boilermakers.
It's not how it goes. We already established this. They're not going to win. They're just not going to win.
You say that, but you actually believe it.
Boiler up.
Yeah, I do actually.
So you believe that they're going to make it, I'm saying.
No. I've been let down way too many times to be this foolish to believe again. I will not believe until they get to the Final Four.
Those are the hardest ones to win, Randy.
Well, that's the only time I'll get excited.
Okay.
Sad.
Will?
You know.
No.
You know, it's not a big weekend, for some, it is a big weekend. Friday afternoon, I'm playing Lyons Municipal Golf Course. You guys familiar with this place?
Mm-hmm.
I haven't played in a little bit. It's supposed to be a beautiful day. I think I'm going to go out there and go a little low. Unfortunately, my wife has made plans without me on Friday night. So your boy will be chilling on that couch. Just making sure no one breaks into the house or anything.
Let's just FaceTime.
While those boys sleep. Yeah, I'll FaceTime you, Dave. Maybe we can go live. And then...
we should.
Saturday, I got a birthday party to go to. You're probably like, oh, man, that's going to be lit. Yeah, he's turning 2.
Mm.
So we out here. I'm going to go do that. And no real plans after that. There's talk around the town about maybe it being a potty training weekend. And I'm going to be straight up honest with you. I'm not looking forward to it. I don't want to clean up any messies and any nappies this weekend, but I think I'm going to be in. I'm going to do that. So it is what it is, but not a big weekend. It's probably good. Probably going to get in that garden, yo. You want to come over?
I haven't even seen your place yet, man.
I know. I need to have you guys over now that we have actual furniture that is in the inside of our home. We'll see. I'll put something on the books. Now that we got the grill and stuff, you guys want me to grill you some vegetables?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'd rather it be like a ribeye or something, but whatever.
It's fun. I mean,
maybe some turbot.
Bring over some turbot and some ribeye.
Okay. Great.
I'd have a master's party, but I'm going to be there. Just kidding. I'm only going to be there for Tuesday, so I'll be back.
Tuesday?
Tuesday. Stop. Tuesday practice round is perfect for your boy.
Sounds great.
It's going to be dope, man.
Must be nice.
Is that all she wrote? Long episode. These bit madness ones get out of control.
Let's get out of here.
All right. See you guys.
Bye.